stringy.
It's like popcorn.
What's up, everyone? I'm Chris. We got Steph behind the camera, and we're hungry to travel. We are here on the island of Phuket, Thailand, and we love a good night market. Lucky for us, Thailand is chock full of them. So today, we're gonna head to the Lad Yai Sunday Walking Street Night Market. We are super hungry and really excited to see what kind of yummy things we can find to eat. So let's get going. We're in the market now, and it's located on the historical Thalang Road in the old town of Phuket. And we just got in, and there's already so many food stalls. So exciting. Ooh, these look good. Look at this. Our first find of the night are these egg battered one bite seafood omelets. So we got one with mussels and one with crab stick. It looks like they give you a little bit of cabbage, some cilantro, and some chili sauce. Look at this, look at the side. They're like half circles. There we go. It's kind of mushy on the inside. The outside is super crispy, but the inside is really kind of mushy. The batter hasn't really cooked through. Got a little bit of an egg taste on the top, but with that sweet chili sauce though, that's good. And the mussel was super juicy. One of my favorite things in the world is the imitation crab stick. You can see there, the inside is still really soft and juicy almost. That crab stick though, my favorite. Put a little bit of cilantro. They're almost like a Japanese takoyaki ball, actually. So tasty. Let's see what else we can find.
Mochi ice cream. Let's get one of these. So we have one milk tea. Look at this little guy. I got the milk tea, the Thai milk tea, which I feel like is the right choice when you're here in Thailand. I've never actually had mochi ice cream before, so I'm really looking forward to this. It's so hot, it's already melting, and you can see it's steaming here. Here we go. So cold. The milk tea flavor is so strong, and the outside of it is chewy like a mochi. Wow, these are so good. Aroi mat. Very good. delicious. These are so refreshing right now as well, because it is a hot evening. So this is the perfect little thing to cool off with. That is cold. And they're actually making them right here and then freezing them. So it's pretty cool. These are delicious though. So let's take these for a walk. We're back in Turkey. These smell good. I think we should get some, whatever it is. Interested to try these. They really do smell good grilling over there. So the lady said that these are called kanom da, and they're made of coconut meat, brown sugar, and glutinous rice flour. So they sound really good, and they're hot, fresh off the grill. So look at this. Oh, they are sticky. Look at that. You can see on the leaf there. Wow, look at that. Oh, so it's pretty sticky. You can see all the glutinous rice there and the brown color from the sugar. Oh, that is hot. Very chewy from the glutinous rice, but you can't actually distinguish the pieces of rice. So it's got a nice texture of the coconut meat in there as well. And nice and sweet. Ooh, this is tasty. I'm really mad. Oh, very good. This is lovely. A sweet one. Very, very nice. You can see the pieces of coconut in there. There's quite a large amount of coconut, actually. It's so nice and brown from the brown sugar. This is a really nice, sweet little treat. It's really cool how these are also cooked in the coconut leaf on the grill like this behind me. Really imparts a nice flavor to it from the leaf itself. Nice and crispy too. So there's two rows of food stalls on the inside of the street and on the outside where all the shops are. Quite a few of them are still open, or there's little pop-up shops selling clothes and jewelry and different things like that. So got a little bit of everything here. It's really nice actually just walking along Thalong Road itself. It was actually the first on the island to get rid of all the overhead kind of spider's web of electrical cables and put them underground. And it's really allowed the beautiful Peranakan architecture to really shine through.
Interesting. Those are cooking up real fast. No idea what they are, but we're gonna get some.
Wow.
Khao kriap. Wow.
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 Yeah.
Khao kriap. Wow.
Yeah. Super.
Kakiao wow.
Yes.
Kakiao wow.
Wow.
Kakiao wow.
Yeah.
Look at these. It looks like almost like a flatbread, really thin pita.
Oh, huge.
Got sesame seeds in them. Let's take one out. So these are huge, and apparently they're called kakek. Wow. They're really delicate, super delicate and crispy. Look at that.
So thin?
Yeah, really thin. It's almost like a rice cracker feeling.
Mm.
Oh.
Mm.
They're sweet. Mm. So delicate and crispy. Mm. A little bit of sweetness to them. And honestly, just tastes like almost like a shrimp cracker, but no shrimp taste. Just kind of like a little bit of sweet. The crunch of the sesame seeds as well. Mm. This is a fun snack. And it's so big. Wow. These are tasty. And it comes with two as well, so don't worry. Steph's gonna get one too.
Fried pizza? Yes, please. Chicken. Oh. So we found a good spot out of the road of all the busyness to try this Penang chicken fried pizza. Look at this puppy. Mmm, that is cheesy. Ooh, I was not expecting cheese. Mmm, that is nice. It's spicy. It's got a nice taste of the Penang to it, and it is cheesy, but let me take another bite to really get into this.
Stringy.
There's a ton of chicken in there. And the Penang flavor, oh my gosh. It really tastes just like a Penang curry. Nice and spicy, lovely peanut flavor to it as well. This is actually amazing. Actually packed with the chicken, the Penang, and the cheese. I don't know what I was expecting, but this is just like a Penang curry pocket of deliciousness. I'm really, really pleased with this decision. Ah, cheese! This other half of the market on the other side of Phalang actually has a lot of food stalls as well. So this market has so much food.
So this is GOONG 10, and this is a dancing shrimp salad. And we've actually been trying to find this throughout our travels here in Thailand. We haven't been able to because it's super rare. So this market actually has it. And you can see here, look at the shrimp. They're all jumping. So they're live shrimp. So it's a shrimp salad, but all the shrimp are still alive. And they're jumping.
They're dancing.
They're dancing. So if I open this, I'm not sure if they're gonna jump at me or not, or try to escape, but
I think they might.
They're gonna go into my belly though. You guys are free. Oh man, look at them. Whew. Oh, they're jumping. They're dancing. That one just landed on my shoe. All right, here we go. They're jumping out.
Oh my God.
Wow, look at that. So they're tiny, tiny little shrimp. Oh, it's dancing on my spoon. Here we go. Ooh, that's spicy. It just jumped out. It's like popcorn. With the red onion and the cilantro, it's super tasty. They're making me work for this food. They do have like a shrimp taste to them because they're raw. They don't taste like cooked shrimp, but they're just really crunchy. Oh wow, that guy was huge. Okay, I gotta eat all this before they jump away.
Can you feel them wriggle in your mouth?
Not really. Oh, they're jumping. Such a rare dish to find here in Thailand. So cool. And they're making a mess of our clothes because they're jumping everywhere. We're so happy that we found this. This is unbelievable.
Look at all of them. There's tons. Do you feel them wriggling in your hand? Oh, they're sharp. You know what? They're splashing all over me. They're actually kind of crispy and crunchy and salty because of all like the lime juice and everything that she put on them. But you really actually can't tell that they're raw and alive, oddly enough. Huh, this is good. Huh. It's kind of weird, but it's actually quite good. What a unique Thai specialty. I think I might just have to dance my way through this market with my dance and shrimp. So it's about 7:30 now and it is packed. There are so many people here. It's hard to move. Saw these little fish pancakes earlier and wanted to come back for one. They're pretty much finished up for the night, but they said they'd make us one more cream one special. So I'm excited for this. We've got our fish pancake fresh off the griddle. Awesome, so good. It is piping hot and crispy on the outside. Let's see if we can get this guy out. Oh, look at this little fishy! Full of the custard cream. It's actually really heavy. Look at this guy. Custard cream is really nice. But it's lovely and just a little bit sweet. It's so hefty, so heavy. It's packed with the cream on the inside. This is good. It kind of reminds me of like a sweet cupcake or something. The texture and the flavor of it. This is lovely.
How are you, Matt?
Thank you. And she recommended the custard and cream was the best one to try, and I would have to say she's right. Look at all that custard cream on the inside. It's almost similar color and kind of texture to the batter, but it tastes quite a bit different. It's lovely and sweet. So glad we caught them just as they were finishing up and they could make us one last little fish. It's perfect.
They even have karaoke at this market. Maybe we'll go up and have a sing. I love me some fish cakes. Guys, twirling. Look at this sausage looking fish cake. It's still spinning. It smells spicy. Wow, packed. With green onion, that's hot. Oh, lemongrass flavor, all over it, It honestly tastes like a fish cake curry. Curry in fish cake form. Alright, Mac. Super tasty, wow. This is a good fish cake.
So lovely at night with all the lights on, and you can really see the beautiful buildings and all the colors, as well as with the market. It's just really, really pretty. This is hot, tiring business exploring this night market. So I think after a long evening, we need a cold drink to cool us off. Let's get a mango drink. Just three different kinds of mango shakes, and we got ours with yogurt. This looks so refreshing. Look at that, so thick. Oh. Oh wow, that is delicious. So thick, it takes you like 2-3 seconds just to suck it up the straw. That's so nice, it's not too sweet. Such a strong mango flavor. That mango is really ripe and tasty. The yogurt at the bottom is a nice creamy addition. Kind of sour, it goes well with the sweet mango. Kind of reminds me of a mango lassi. Oh, that is so refreshing. This is exactly what I needed to finish off this awesome night. This is perfect. Oh, yeah. Thanks for checking out the Sunday Walking Street Night Market with us tonight in Phuket. We hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. If you did, give the video a like and make sure you subscribe to our channel to come on our next food adventure with us. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.